In the outback, there are two things you can rely on. The sun always shining and Sammy's store always being open. Sammy was the proudest shopkeeper in the outback. He always tried his hardest to give his customers exactly what they wanted.
There you go, Alice.
I don't know what we'd do without you, Sammy.
Ah, it's nice of you to say so, Alice. If my customers are happy, then I'm happy too.
Hooray!
Good day, Mitzi.
Hi, Mitzi.
What can I get you? If you want it, I've got it.
Oh, great. Can I have a yo-yo?
A yo-yo. Right. Don't fancy a skipping rope, I suppose.
Nah, I really want a yo-yo.
I don't seem to have one.
Sammy, you said you had everything.
I'm sorry, Mitzi.
Never mind. Bye, Sammy.
Bye, Mitzi.
Sammy was worried. What use was a shopkeeper who couldn't give people what they wanted?
Hello, Sammy.
Morning. Fill her up, Josie.
Okay.
Hi, Alice.
Morning, Buster. Frank, have you heard?
Heard what?
Mitzi asked Sammy for a yo-yo and he didn't have one.
Well, I think Sammy's a bit worried.
We'd better see if he's okay, Buster.
Sammy was a bit worried. If he didn't have a yo-yo for Mitzi, maybe there were other things he didn't have too.
Ah, bed springs. I don't have bed springs or cookie cutters.
Hi, Sammy.
Frank, Buster, how are you?
How are you today?
I'm fine.
Are you sure? Alice told us about the yo-yo.
She did? Oh. Can I get you something?
We've bought our grocery list.
Yes. Oh, I have everything on the list. Absolutely everything.
Well, great.
Do you want me to deliver this afternoon?
Thanks, Sammy. Yeah, thanks.
Oh, if my customers are happy, then I'm happy too. Nuts! I haven't got nuts.
Later, Sammy had to deliver Frank and Buster's groceries to the homestead.
Thanks for looking after the store, Josie.
No problem, Sammy. Have a nice trip.
But Sammy's day was getting worse and worse.
Sammy! Wait!
See you later, Josie! Good day, George!
Afternoon, Sammy! Sammy! Oh, dear. Sammy, wait! Beans everywhere. Oh, dear.
I hope Sammy comes soon. I'm starving.
Don't worry, Buster. You can always rely on Sammy.
He's here.
Good day, all.
Hi, Sammy. Am I glad to see you.
Afternoon, Sammy. I think Buster's hungry.
Made it just in time, then. I'll get your groceries out the back. Ah! Where are they? They're gone. All gone.
No Billy Beans.
Here's your problem, Sammy. It must have come undone.
What's up?
Sammy's lost the groceries.
Oh, have you got any yo-yos yet, Sammy? Only Ned wants one too.
I'd like a green one.
I'm sorry, Mitzi, but I haven't got any. Sorry, everyone.
Ah, don't worry, Sammy. We'll help you find the groceries.
No need, Buster.
Oh, Sammy, I think these belong to you.
George has beaten us to them.
Thanks a bunch, George. I'm really sorry.
It's okay, Sammy, and thank you, George.
Oh, Sammy really is having a bad day.
Yeah.
Back at the shop, Sammy made a list of all the things he didn't have.
Hairbrushes. Something else I haven't got. Aha! Ah! Archie, good day. I didn't hear you come in. Yes, there's normally a tingle-dingle at your door. no, now my bell isn't working.
Oh, dear. Oh, well, I wondered if you had any tennis balls.
Tennis balls? Oh, yes.
Oh, dear.
I say. I'm really sorry, Archie.
This was the first time that Sammy had ever split a bag. It was the worst day he'd ever had. The next morning, it was the first time that anyone could remember Sammy's store not opening.
I can't see him.
Everyone was worried about him.
Morning, Alice. You're up nice and early.
Morning. Sammy hasn't opened his store.
But his store's always open.
Not today. And we can't find him anywhere.
Come on, Buster. I think Sammy may need help. Get the gate, Ned.
I'm getting the gate, Frank.
Oh, thanks, Ned. Oh, and if you see Sammy, could you ask him about the yo-yos?
Hi, Josie. Have you found him yet?
Hi, Buster. No.
It's like he's just disappeared. Oh, Sammy, you're here.
G'day.
We were wondering why you haven't opened up your store.
I can't do it anymore.
Do what?
Be a shopkeeper. I let Mitzi down with her yo-yo. I lost your groceries. I can't twirl a bag anymore. Even the bell on the shop door doesn't work.
You know, Sammy, perhaps you were just having a bad day.
That's right. Everyone has them.
They do.
And just because you're having a bad day doesn't mean you're a bad shopkeeper.
But what if I don't have something somebody wants again? I made this list of things I don't have. It's really long. Look.
You can't keep everything in your store, Sammy. That would be impossible.
And besides, everyone really misses you.
Really? Maybe I was just having a bad day. Yeah, you're right, Buster. You're right, Frank. I'm gonna open the store. Thanks.
We're here to help.
Everyone was excited when they heard Sammy was going to open his store again. Things just weren't the same without his friendly face at the counter.
There, good as new.
Thanks. Good day, all. I'd just like to say that from now on, Sammy's store will always be open. Always a pleasure, Alice.
Sammy looks like his old self again, Frank.
Yeah, great, isn't it?
So, it was yo-yos you wanted, wasn't it?
Whoa, yeah!
Please, Sammy.
Well, guess what I've got here.
Whoa.
I couldn't find any, so I decided to make you one each instead.
Oh, great!
Wow, and it's green. Thanks, Sammy.
Three cheers for Sammy.
Thanks to the Koala Brothers, Sammy realised how much his store meant to everyone in the outback. He also knew that if he had a bad day, everyone would understand. After all, no one's perfect, even the best shopkeeper in the outback. One day, Sammy the shopkeeper was collecting honey from his beehive. Sammy loved his bees. Every morning he checked to see that they'd all arrived home safely.
G'day, Dolly. And you, Sally. Mandy. G'day, Trixie. Bessie. Bessie, where are you?
On this particular day, Sammy discovered one of his bees hadn't returned home. Bessie was missing.
Oh, don't worry, everyone. I'll find Bessie.
Meanwhile, at the homestead, something else was missing.
Have you been at the honey again, Buster?
Sorry, Frank. Sammy's honey is so nice, I can't resist it.
good thing we keep a spare jar in the cupboard.
Cooey!
Morning. Hi, Mitzi.
Thanks for the honey, Buster. It was delicious.
Buster. Oh, well, we're here to help.
Huh? Oh, it's Sammy. He's wearing something really funny.
Bessie, where are you? Yonder here?
I like your hat.
Oh, good day, Ned. Thanks.
Morning, Sammy. What can we do for you?
Good day, all. Have you seen Bessie?
Who's Bessie?
She's one of my bees. She hasn't returned to the hive.
We haven't seen her, have we, Buster?
No. Sorry, Sammy.
It's only one little bee. You must have loads more, Sammy.
Oh, every bee is different. They're all important.
Oh.
Maybe she's in town. I've searched everywhere for her. She must be lost. She could be anywhere.
Ooh. What's up with him?
Ned's scared of bees.
Don't worry, Sammy. We'll help you find Bessie, won't we, Buster?
Sure.
We're here to help.
Later that morning, George the postman was just finishing his tea break.
Well, just what I needed, a nice cup of tea. Ah, morning, Buster. What you doing?
Hi, George. Sammy's lost one of his bees. You haven't seen it, have you?
Sorry, Buster. Haven't seen a soul until you came along. Poor little thing. I'll keep my eyes open for it.
Thanks, George. Got a dash.
Bye.
Meanwhile, at the homestead, Frank was getting everyone ready to search for Bessie.
What do you want me to do with this, Frank?
It's for catching bees with.
Oh.
The post is in position, Frank.
Good work, Buster.
Ned had been getting ready too. He'd made a hat to keep the bees away.
Right. The first thing we need to know, Sammy, is how we'll be able to recognise Bessie.
Huh? Hello, everyone.
Ask Ned about the box.
Why the box, Ned?
Don't like bees.
Ahem. So, how will we know it's Bessie then?
Yeah, all bees look the same.
But they don't all sound the same. Bessie sounds like this. Bzzz, bzzz,
bzzz. Oh, that's great.
Bzzz, bzzz. But that's not right, Mitzi. Sammy's doing this. Bzzz, bzzz,
bzzz. Well, that's great. Now I think Buster and I should search the outback in the plane. Oh, good idea, Frank. The rest of us can search the homestead.
19, 20. Oh, George! Caught me doing my exercises. Any post?
Hi, Archie. Let's have a little look-see at that. Aha!
Ah!
Shh! Listen.
What are we listening to, George?
Oh, it's gone. I thought I could hear Sammy's missing bee.
Missing?
Yeah, poor little Bessie, somewhere out there, all alone.
Oh, dear.
Are you sure we'll see anything from up here, Frank?
Try your telescope, Buster.
Down there! I saw something, Frank. I really did. There it is again. It must be Bessie.
Where? Let me have a look.
Can you see her, Frank? Can you see Bessie?
When was the last time you cleaned your telescope, Buster?
Sorry, Frank.
Well, let's go back and see how the others are getting on.
The others had been searching all over the homestead. There was still no sign of Bessie.
Where are you, little Bessie? Sammy wants you home now.
You must really like Bessie, Sammy.
I love all my bees. Ned?
Yes?
Why don't you like bees?
Bees sting you.
They do if you upset them, Ned. You know, it's best never to touch bees or go anywhere near them unless you're a beekeeper like me. Then you'll be safe.
Okay. Any luck?
No.
It's no good. I don't think we're ever going to find Bessie.
We've just got to keep looking, Sammy.
Hello, everyone.
George, are you all right?
Yeah, I've just finished my rounds and I'm here to lend a hand. Any news?
She could be anywhere.
Mitch is right.
If there's one thing I know, Sammy, the outback is full of surprises. You should never give up.
Thanks, George.
What's up, Ned?
Sorry, Ned. No post for you in there.
I can hear something. It's buzzing.
Hey, I can hear it too. Bessie, it's you. Oh, don't go away. Bessie.
Come here, Bessie.
Over here, quickly. Oh, no, we've lost her. She's gone again.
She can't be far.
It's all right. Look.
Ah.
Oh, she's really beautiful.
I think she likes you, Ned.
Well done, Ned.
Come on, little Bessie. Let's get you home. There you go, Bessie. Home sweet home.
Later that day, Sammy decided that everyone who'd helped find Bessie deserved a reward. A jar of his special honey.
Delicious!
From a tea break tomorrow.
Thanks, Sammy.
So everything turned out well in the end. Ned wasn't frightened of bees anymore, and Sammy was happy that Bessie was safe, because all life is special, no matter how small. Sammy the echidna ran his general store like clockwork, and he always opened up at the same time every day to welcome his customers. That's because Sammy had some help from a little friend.
Thanks, little bird. That's right. It's time to open up. Morning.
Morning, Sammy.
Sammy had grown used to having the cuckoo clock in his store. The little bird popped out to help him keep things running on time.
Well, Alice, what can I get you?
Meanwhile, at the Koala Brothers homestead, Mitzi the possum was running late.
Morning, Mitzi.
Morning.
Fancy joining us for toast and honey?
I'd love to, Buster, but I've got to get to Sammy's store.
She must really be in a hurry not to want toast and honey.
Yeah, she must really need her groceries.
But Mitzi wasn't in a hurry to get her groceries. Yay! She had another reason for wanting to get to Sammy's store fast.
Is it going to come out soon, Sammy?
Any second now, Mitzi.
Morning, little bird.
You really love that little bird, don't you, Mitzi?
Yeah, I do. It's so pretty and it makes such a happy noise when it pops out to say hello. Oh, I'd love to have a clock like that more than anything in the world.
Well, why don't you have it then?
Really? Like, take it home and look after it?
Yeah.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, Sammy.
Though Sammy was very fond of his cuckoo clock, he liked nothing more than making his customers happy.
Would you like it wrapped?
No thanks, Sammy. But can you put it in a bag?
Mitzi couldn't wait to surprise everyone.
Hey, everyone! Guess what I've got in my bag?
A tin of Billy Beans?
A big red rock?
Nah, not even close.
Can you give us a clue?
Okay, but you've got to close your eyes. You should be getting a clue right about now.
Sammy's clock!
Yeah! Sammy gave it to me. Isn't it beautiful?
Oh, wow. What a nice present.
Sammy's very kind.
I know! It's the best present anyone's ever given me. Well, I'd better show the little bird to its new home.
Though Sammy was pleased he made Mitzi happy, he was beginning to miss the friendly tick of his cuckoo clock.
Oh. Hi, Sammy. I'm ready for our little lunch break. Oh, I'm starving.
Oh, is that the time already? I haven't made the sandwiches yet.
Oh.
Sorry, George. I'll go and make them right away.
Without his cuckoo clock, Sammy had completely forgotten what the time was. He'd never missed his lunch break with George before.
Oh, thanks, Sammy. It was worth the wait.
A pleasure, George. Well, I suppose we'd better get back to it then.
Isn't there something missing, Sammy?
Oh, you want dessert?
No, the little birdie, the one that cuckoos to tell us lunchtime is over.
Oh, sorry, George. I gave the cuckoo clock to Mitzi.
Oh, I really liked seeing that birdie. It was the best bit. Well, thanks for lunch, Sammy. Yep. I'll see you later.
Bye, George.
Later that day, the Koala Brothers arrived to get some fuel and drop off their grocery list with Sammy.
Hi, Frank. Buster.
Fill her up, Josie.
To the top, Frank.
Right to the top, thanks.
Oh. Josie, are you all right?
It's Sammy. He looks a bit sad.
Maybe we should go and see if he's okay.
Oh, thanks, Frank.
No trouble, Josie.
We're here to help.
Oh, good day, Frank. Buster.
Hi, Sammy. We've brought our grocery list.
Everything all right? Could I ask you a question? Sure. If you had something you really liked, but you gave it to someone because they really liked it too, it'd be wrong to ask for it back, wouldn't it? I guess it would, Sammy. Yeah, I thought so. Well, I'll better get this little lot together. Shall I deliver tomorrow morning? That'd be great, Sammy.
Josie was right. Sammy did look a little sad. The Koala Brothers couldn't help feeling Sammy's question had something to do with his cuckoo clock. That night, all was quiet on the homestead.
See you in the morning, little bird. Night, Frank! Night, Buster!
Night, Mitzi!
Night-night then, Buster.
Night-night, Frank.
It looked like it was going to be a long night at the homestead. The next morning, Sammy was ready for his early morning grocery delivery.
Is he coming?
Morning, Sammy.
Good day, all. You're early this morning.
Actually, it's you that's late, Sammy. Everyone's been waiting for you to open up.
Late? I'm late, and I haven't made my deliveries yet. Oh, dear, I'm really sorry, everyone.
Don't worry, Sammy. I'll look after the store.
Oh, thanks, Josie. I'll be back as soon as I can.
Without the cuckoo clock, poor Sammy didn't have a clue what the time was.
Bye.
He really relied on it to be on time.
I say, where's Sammy's clock?
Back at the homestead, Mitzi's cuckoo clock had kept everyone awake all night.
Oh, good day all. I'm sorry I'm late.
Morning, Sammy!
Oh, morning.
In the kitchen?
Oh, thanks. What's wrong, Sammy?
Oh, it's the cuckoo clock. I know it was a nice thing to do to give it to Mitzi, but now it's gone from my store, I can't keep on time.
I really miss that little bird.
Oh, I wish there was something we could do to help.
I know, but what? Mitzi really loves that clock.
Morning.
Morning, Mitzi.
Sleep well?
Nah, I didn't sleep a wink.
Was it the cuckoo clock?
Yeah. You know, I really love that little bird, but you can't keep it quiet.
Have you thought that maybe the homestead isn't the best place for it?
Oh, yeah, I suppose. But it was a present from Sammy. If I gave it back to him, it might hurt his feelings.
I've got an idea that might suit everybody.
You have?
Hi!
Good day, all. What can I get you? Can you hear a ticking noise?
Mitzi's got a favour to ask you.
Sammy, this is the nicest present anyone has ever given me. But I was wondering, could you keep it for me in the store?
Are you sure, Mitzi?
Yeah.
Ah, well, I think that's a wonderful idea, and I know just the place to put it.
Yeah.
There.
Right.
What do you
think? Yeah. Yeah.
I recognise that noise.
Oh, yeah.
Thanks to the Koala Brothers, Sammy was happy again. Sammy realised that the right place for the cuckoo clock was where everyone could enjoy it. And from that day on, Sammy's store was always open on time.
If you're in trouble and you need someone to help you out, there's no need to whistle and there's no need to shout. Hey, 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 hey.